السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الأمانة وأدى الرسالة ونصح الأمة فكشف الله به الغمة وتركنا على المحاجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فاللهم يا أرحم الراحمين اجمعنا به في أعلى عليين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا اللهم آمين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We testify that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last and sealed messenger. Him alayhi salatu wa salam. He mentioned, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَن تَضِلُّوا بَعْدِي أَبَدًا كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وَسُنَّتِي. He said alayhi salatu wa salam, I've left amongst you something if you follow step by step, you will never go misguided. What is it, Ya Rasulullah? He says, alayhi salatu wassalam, the book of Allah and the sunnah, the traditions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the curriculum of life. This is the curriculum, the way of life as a believer. This is what guides you in every step of the way. And we need to stick to it. We need to stick to it if we want to be successful in this dunya or in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to stick to the deen and hold tight to it. But dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Oh, you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how we ought to be feared, and don't die except in a status of complete submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Commit to that deed to the last breath. Only submitting your will and your actions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only judging your ways of actions and your deeds according to the Quran and Sunnah. My dear brothers and sisters, our topic today is searching for happiness in times of temptations, in times of tests. We as an ummah, as a nation of Islam, we as nation who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, We are being tested in so many ways. We're being tested in so many ways by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We look at our brothers and sisters in Palestine. This is where the focus, this is where the lenses is right now. This is one big test for the whole ummah. But the brothers and sisters are being tested everywhere. Not only in their deen, but also as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. The brothers and sisters of Islam are being tested in so many ways, as Allah mentioned in the Quran, that we will be tested. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ, something of fear. وَالْجُوعِ, hunger. وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ, and decreasing wealth. وَالْأَنفُسِ, souls, lost of souls. So many souls are being lost. وَالثَّمَرَاتِ, the fruits that you get as well. Allah will test you in every aspect. We thought that we'll say La ilaha illallah and we'll get to Jannah right away. It takes time, it takes effort. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the beginning of Surah Al-Ankabut, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think that they will say, I'm a believer, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, that's it, and they get to Jannah? Absolutely not. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think they will say, I'm a believer, and they will not be tested? Allah continues the rest of the ayah to say, فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Indeed, we have tested those before you, for Allah will know those who are truthful to their iman, those who are truthful to their belief, and those who are liars. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be one of the truthful ones. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, these tests and tribulations are meant to cleanse us. These tests and tribulations are meant to get us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to follow the Quran and Sunnah in order to be successful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Do you think that you're going to enter Jannah? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will know those who strive for His sake and those who are the patient ones. So are you going to be from the patient ones who strive for His sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or are you going to give up with the first strike? And how do you go about that? You need to understand the nature of the fitan, the tests and tribulations that you're going through. And there are so many of them. There are so many of them. Absolutely, we can't cover all of them in the khutbah. But today we're going to cover a few. A few of the fitan that the ummah has been exposed to. Every day, day in and day out. And we need to understand the nature of this fitna so we can understand how to fight against it. So we can understand how to help each other to get out of this fitna. So we can understand where we can find true happiness. We live in a world where things are mixed out. There's delusions about what's truth and what's not. Rasulullah ﷺ even referred to that. That will come days where things be like that. So how can mal khalas? How can we get out of this? My dear brothers and sisters, as I mentioned, you need to understand first. Understand what's fitna. Huzayfa ibn al-Yaman radiallahu anhu, one of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, كَانَ النَّاسُ يَسْأَلُونَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ عَنِ الْخَيْرِ وَكُنْتُ أَسْأَلُهُ عَنِ الشَّرِّ مَخَافَةَ أَنْ يُدْرِكَنِي. All people were asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all people were asking Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the good things to do. However, Hudhayfa, he said, I used to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the evil things that might happen, about the fitna and the tests and tribulations that might attack me. So I am aware how to defend myself. So when it attacks me, I know how to defend myself. I know how to defend my belief against this test. The same companion, Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman, he narrates another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, تُعْرَضُ الْفِتَنُ عَلَى الْقُلُوبِ كَالْحَصِيرِ عُودًا عُودًا. That the fitan, the tribulations, the tests will be exposed to the believers as if it is like the hasir. The hasir is the carpet in most of the Arabian Peninsula that's made of pieces from tree. Think of it as branches. They are so close to each other to cause that carpet for you easy to sit on. Rasulullah ﷺ has given you a metaphor to tell you how close that these sticks to each other, the fitan, the tests and tribulations will be exposed to you just like that, one after another, that close. تعرض الفتن على القلوب كالحصير عودا عودا, one after another, close to each other. فأي قلب أشربها أشربها نكت فيه نكتة سوداء, وأي قلب أنكرها نكتت فيه نكتة بيضاء. For the heart that accepts and absorbs these fitan and take it in and fall in the trap, there will be a black dot in your heart. And for the hearts that rejects these fitan and defend their hearts and their belief against these traps, they will be the winners. نكتت فيه نكتة سوداء نكتة بيضاء. For the hearts that object these fitan and reject it and only follow the Quran and Sunnah, their hearts will have a one dot, one white dot. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continues in this beautiful hadith to give us this metaphor. And he says, حتى تصير على قلبين, until people will be either of two hearts. على أبيض مثل الصفا فلا تضره فتنة ما دامت السماوات والأرض. The result is that, as I mentioned, two hearts. One, white like a white stone, which will not be harmed by any turmoil, will not be harmed by any fitna, will not be harmed by any test. ما دامت السماوات والأرض, as long as her earth and heaven exist. وقلب أسود مربادا كالكور مجخيا لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا إلا ما أشرب من هواء. And another heart, the heart that absorbed these fitan, these tests, and taking it lightly. What happened to that heart? It became so dark. لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا. It can't distinguish good from evil no more. It can't distinguish good deeds from evil deeds no more. إلا ما أشرب من هواء. Only following their desires and passion, fulfilling the means and the desires of the nafs, of the souls, and not the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we only know that those who follow their hawa, those who follow their passion, follow their desires, what's the destination? وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنِ اتَّبْعَ هَوَاهُ بِغَيْرِ هُدًى مِّنَ اللَّهِ. Allah says in another ayah, who is more misguided than the person who followed their desire away from the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, again, this is what we're exposed to. The fitan, the tests that test our belief. So what is some of these fitan, some of these tests or turmoil? When you are faced by a calamity, you sometimes are being tested in your deen, your own belief. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he says in the hadith that narrated on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, بادروا بالأعمال فتانا كقطع الليل المظلم يصبح الرجل مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا ويمسي مؤمنا ويصبح كافرا ويبيع دينه بعرض من الدنيا. In this hadith that was narrated by Abi Huraira, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, hasten to doing good deeds, for there will be coming a day where the man will be selling his deen. For what? وعرض من الدنيا قليل, for something that will go away in a couple of days, a pleasure that was just temporary. You might be sinning for a sake of pleasure that is temporary. يصبح الرجل مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا. A man will wake up Muslim and end up the night as a disbeliever. A man will end the night as a believer and wake up as a disbeliever. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us that for us to protect ourselves from losing our deen is that we need to hasten to do more good deeds. For when these times come, where people are losing their deen day in and day out, you are the one whose hold is strong. For what? Your only focus on the akhirah. Your only focus is doing good deeds and decreasing the amount of sayyat in your scale. Increasing the amount of hasanat in your scale. That's your focus. Jannah, nothing else. No dunya. For when you focus on the matters of this life, you're gonna be very easy target for for the tests and tribulations. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, unfortunately, we get to mix culture and deen sometimes, culture and religion. A lot of times things are passed around from one culture to another. And this is how the shaitan gets to you. This is how the shaitan gets to you. Think and reflect on the people before you. When the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them and said, this is the deen of Allah, this is what you have to worship only. What did he say? هَذَا مَا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهِ أَبَاءَنَا. This is what we found our ancestors doing. This is our culture. This is our tradition. What are you here changing? The same thing. The deen has been filled. Our religion has been filled with a lot of traditions that comes with culture. And sometimes it's passed on like that. And your duty as a believer is to do more search, do more work to understand your deen, understand what's culture and what's tradition, what's deen and what's not. For everything is halal. But when it comes to the ibadah of Allah, when it comes to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the way He told you to worship Him. Not according to your tradition, not according to your desire. Can you pray Dhuhr 5 rak'ah? Absolutely you can. Allah said it's 4, then it's 4. You please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how He wants to be pleased, not how you want to be pleasing Him. So subhanallah, look at the Iblis. The shaitan, he always comes to you from that angle as well. In the hadith that was narrated by Sabrat ibn Abi Fakih, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starts the hadith saying, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ قَعَدَ لِبْنِ آدَمْ بِأَطْرُقِهِ فَقَعَدَ لَهُ بِطَرِيقِ الْإِسْلَامِ فَقَالَ تُسْلِمْ وَتَذَرَ دِينَكَ وَدِينَ أَبَائِكَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in this hadith something that complements what I just said. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, the shaitan, the devil, has stepped in the road for any believer to Islam. And he says, do you leave the deen, the religion of your fathers and grandfathers? Are you leaving your own traditions? The same thing happened to Abi Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, the one who defended Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam with everything. What happened to him in the deathbed? His companions were next to him. Good companions? Absolutely not. From the biggest of the mushrikeen, from the biggest of the disbelievers, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him and he said to his uncle, Ya Ammi, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ قُلْهَا كَلِمَةً وَحَاجُّكَ فِيهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ رَسُولُ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says to his uncle, say just one word, La ilaha illallah. There is no God worthy worship except Allah. Just that one word so I can use that to defend you in front of Allah. What did his friends say? They said, are you going to leave the religion of your fathers and grandfathers? Are you going to leave your traditions now? Now that you are in a place of weakness in the deathbed, are you going to leave your traditions now? So understand that some of these fitan, some of these tests that we face, a lot of it are bid'ah, innovations and the deen, passed on from generation to another. People think it's the deen, but it is not. So it's a duty upon you as a believer to get to understand your deen, get to understand your religion, get to understand Islam, get to understand the traditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dig in the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the history of the companions, the dedication of for this deen, their dedication for that deen. How did this deen came to you today? It was on their flesh. My dear brothers and sisters, this is not the only fitna they were facing, our own deen. We're losing the authentic deen. This is the first one, and the very major one that we're facing. Another one that's very connected to it, fitna to inqilab al-mawazin, the fitna in which nobody knows what is the truth and what's right, what's wrong. Who do we listen to? Who's saying right things? Who's saying authentic hadith? Who's not saying authentic hadith? Who's the sheikh that tries to teach the right things? Who's teaching the wrong things? Why? Because there are people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about that. People will come and will destroy your deen like that. People will be The one who are regarded as truthful is going to be regarded as untruthful. And those who are regarded as untruthful will be regarded as truthful. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in this hadith that was narrated by Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu as well. He says, سَيَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ سَنَوَاتٌ خَدَّاعَاتٌ. There will be coming days in which there will be years of treachery, years of confusion. يُصَدَّقُ فِيهَا الْكَاذِبُ وَيُكَذَّبُ فِيهَا الصَّادِقُ وَيُؤْتَمَنُ فِيهَا الْخَائِنُ وَيُخَوَّنُ فِيهَا الْأَمِينُ. In which the truthful will be regarded as untruthful. The untruthful will be regarded as truthful. The Ameen, the one who's honest, is being regarded as unhonest. And the one who's not honest is being regarded as honest. Everything is confusing. How do you get behind that? How you get past that? Knowledge. Your knowledge of the deen. If you don't know your Quran, you can't get past that. If you don't know your hadith, you can't get past that. And you have to know a good majority of it. Do your best. That's what you gotta do. Just do your best. Do what you can do to learn more about your deen. For things will be very confusing. And you can't take one piece to interpret the whole situation. You have to do your best to learn as much as you can. The more you learn, the picture will be more clear. And you'll be standing more firm against any tribulation. You'll be standing more firm against any test when it comes to attack your belief. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us gain more knowledge of the deen and make it easy for us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه ولي المستغفرين. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, we're talking about searching for happiness in the times of tests and tribulations. The whole ummah is facing a great test. How do you find your own sanity in that? How do you find solid ground for your deen in the middle of all of that? We talked about the nature of the fitan, the nature of the turmoil, the tests that are being exposed in our faces. We talked about the test of the deen and how can we tackle that with knowledge. There are so many tests in so many ways. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us with the provisions that He gave to us. Allah will test us with the wealth. Allah will test us with women. For my brothers, specifically with women, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith that there is no fitna, there is no test that is left behind me that's more injurious to men than women. The shaitan will cause fitna to our women and use it against us. So be careful, my brothers and sisters. Be careful for falling in the traps of the shaitan. For the shaitan will not go to step 10 first. It will drag you step by step, as Rasulullah will tell us, as the Quran will tell us. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطْوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Don't follow the steps of the shaitan. The shaitan will not tell you commit zina right away. Will tell you, well, just check out that profile. How about you just respond to that message? Slide in these DMs, right? And then before you know it, you're committing zina. Before you know it, you're deep into the haram and you can't get out of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our youth. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, sometimes we look for happiness in the wrong place. Sometimes we look for happiness in the wrong place. Sometimes we think happiness is fulfilling the desires of our souls. Happiness, we think sometimes, is having more wealth. We think sometimes happiness is fulfilling any other desires of the soul, whether that be sexual desire, food desire, strength, whatever it is. But in fact, that's wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent Adam alayhi salam and Iblis to this ground, what did He say subhanahu wa ta'ala? قَالَ اهْبِطَا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فمن اتبع هداي فلا يضل ولا يشقى. Allah says, descend to earth, both of you, Iblis and Adam. فإما يأتينكم مني هدى, when a revelation is sent, when guidance is sent from me to you, فمن اتبع هداي فلا يضل ولا يشقى. Whoever follows that guidance, فلا يضل ولا يشقى. You will never go misguided. You will never go miserable. So here is the key to you. How do you be successful? Follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created you. Remember the curriculum we talked about earlier? The Quran and Sunnah? He told you, this is how you're supposed to live successfully in this dunya and the hereafter. But sometimes we just ignore that. Despite the Quran saying, do not ignore that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on in the next ayah to say, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. And whoever ignores my guidance, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. He will face a very sad and depressed life. You're trying to find a cure to your depression? You're trying to find a cure to your hard and tough times? Remember Allah. Get back to the Quran. Get back to the Sunnah. Look at your actions. Look at your way of life. Is it following the Quran and Sunnah or not? Also try your best to help your community. Help your brothers and sisters. Create an environment for yourself where you can be successful as a believer. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and I'm going to conclude with this story. It was mentioned there was a man, ذو بأس, a man with big strength. He used to visit Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu all the time. He used to visit Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu all the time. And all of a sudden, this man disappeared. فَافْتَقَدَهُ عُمَرُ. Umar ibn al-Khattab mentioned, where's this man? I didn't see him since a long time. The people said to Umar ibn al-Khattab, wallahi, he fell in the fitna of drinking. He's drinking alcohol, meaning he's drinking alcohol. So Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he asked his katib, his writer, to write something for this man. And he wrote him this message. من عمر بن الخطاب إلى فلان بن فلان سلام عليك أما بعد فإني أحمد إليك الله الذي لا إله إلا هو غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. He sent him a message as a reminder. This message is the beginning of Surah Ghafir. The beginning of Surah by the name of Surah Ghafir. In which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, describing himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, غافر الذنب. Allah is the most forgiving for any sins. قابل التوب, the one who accepts repentance. شديد العقاب, severe in punishment. ذي الطول, he's the one who he's filling you with all these generosity of blessings. He has so many bounty upon you. لا إله إلا هو. There is no God except him. إليه المصير. To him we all going. So this is all what he said. Umar ibn al-Khattab to his friend. So when the man saw the message of Umar ibn al-Khattab, he continued to say it so many times. He continued to say it so many times. غافر الذنب قابل التوب شديد العقاب. He continued to say the descriptions of Allah in this ayah. He is the one who accepts repentance. He is the one who forgives the sins. شديد العقاب, the one who is severe in punishment. قد حذرني عقوبته ووعدني أن يغفر لي. He warned me from punishment and he promised me to forgive me. And then he تاب توبة نصوحة. He repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a repentance that is, inshallah, a sincere one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. What do we learn from this story? A lot of us sometimes when we see brothers and sisters falling in the traps of the shaitan, we aid the shaitan upon our brothers and sisters. We're not going to advise them sometimes. Sometimes we bully them about that matter. Unfortunately. But what we need to do is follow the example of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu by asking and advising our brothers and sisters in a good manner with the Quran and Sunnah to guide them to do the right thing. And again, making sure that we're creating an environment that will help us be better believers as Muslims in this dunya and in the highest successful believers in the akhirah, in the highest levels of Jannah. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, in this occasion, I also wanted to mention, we need to do our best to make dua for our brothers and sisters in Palestine. We see them under the aggression of the enemy. We see them under the genocide by the occupier. And unfortunately, as believers around the world, we became in that status for being in a status of hawan, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. He said in the hadith that we mentioned many times in the previous khutbahs, became in that status because we lift the akhirah as a goal. We focused on the dunya as a goal. We lift the hereafter as a goal. And we focus on the dunya and this life, which taking us away from what we need to do to establish the deen. So continue to make dua for them. Continue to support them however you can. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aid our brothers in Palestine. Allahumma, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aid our brothers everywhere. Unfortunately, the ummah is being attacked everywhere. In Congo, in Kashmir, everywhere in the world. So keep making dua and understand that you are a piece of that ummah. And if you are to fix yourself in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are to do better in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rest of the ummah will get better. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, each of us, to do better individually in the eyes of Allah. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit Allahumma ala al-haqq aqdamana وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين ارحمهم برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء. اللهم يا ربي تقبل شهداءهم. اللهم ثبت الأرض من تحت أقدامهم. اللهم ثبت الأرض من تحت أقدامهم. اللهم انصرهم نصرا قريبا مؤذرا. اللهم انصرهم نصرا مبينا. اللهم انصرهم نصرا مبينا. اللهم نصرا عاجلا غير آجل. اللهم نصرا عاجلا غير آجل. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا استقيموا واستووا يرحمني ويرحمكم الله. ساووا صبوركم بين سبيل الصبور بين ثواب الصلاة. صلوا صلاة مودع يرحمني ويرحمكم الله. Straighten your lines, foot to foot, shoulder to shoulder. Pray as if it is your last prayer. استقيموا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين.